This segment of Labatt Buffalo Main Event is brought to you by
MyHockeyLife.com, your online community if you live and breathe hockey.
We are back on Labatt Buffalo Main Event. I'm Brad Ryder along with Bob Gaughan to close things out on the show as we do every week. We've got a commentary and Bob Gaughan's first, so tell him everything, Bob. Be cool.
Brad, Yale, Harvard, Stanford. Those are supposed to be three of the greatest universities in this country. However, if the Bills' offense is any reflection on those universities, they're also the universities that Marv Levy, Dick Geron, Trent Edwards, and Turk Schonert went to. Boy, you and I are happy that we went to Geneseo and Buff State, huh? If you look at these universities and what they brought to the Bills' offense, let's talk about Marv Levy, general manager and personnel. The Bills did not have a second receiver, nor did they have a tight end. That really hurt the scoring in the red zone. The Bills only scored 20 offensive touchdowns. Do you know that that is the least amount that they ever scored in the history of this organization? Doesn't our Harvard grad have to take a little blame for it, for not having a second receiver or a tight end? Talk about the quarterback play. Trent Edwards, quarterback coach Turk Schonert. Trent Edwards struggled with some of the fine points of quarterbacking, Brad, like throwing the football at points. Doesn't the quarterback coach and the quarterback might have something to do with that? Our two Stanford grads and Yale, our head coach, Dick Geron, the most conservative offense you have ever seen in the history of maybe football. And also the fact that Dick Geron struggles picking offensive coordinators. His two in Chicago, John Shoup and Gary Croton, and now his one in Buffalo, Steve Fairchild. He's 0-3. Bills fans and Bear fans, not sad to see these guys go. Hopefully, he makes a good choice and goes 1-4. Brad, I never thought I'd see the day that the Vince Ferragamo, Joe Dufek, and Bruce Matheson-led Bills would score more touchdowns than a current Buffalo Bills team. But these four guys from these three elite universities were able to accomplish that this year.
Congratulations to the Seattle Seahawks for moving on in the NFL playoffs. They defeat the Washington Redskins. And I blame Sean Taylor. Sean Taylor certainly was going to get all the credit if the Washington Redskins won the football game. There's no question about that. He was solely responsible, if you believe what you hear from the broadcasters, for the 14-0 lead that the Redskins held. So as soon as things started to fall apart, I started to wonder, well, what happened to Sean Taylor? Where is he? He was in the starting lineup. We were told that several times. It was also nice to know that Fred Smoot, Chris Collinsworth brought this up, out of all the players on the Redskins, Fred Smoot was the one who seemed to be playing the most inspired following the death of Sean Taylor. Once again, it was a tragic thing that happened, but he's not a part of the football team anymore. I understand the tribute they're paying to him by keeping him in the lineup, but I don't need to hear it week after week, and thankfully we won't hear it anymore this season about this team. It was bound to happen. If they won, it was going to be credit to Sean Taylor. I'm here to say I'm blaming Sean Taylor for the Redskins' loss because, hey, if it was going to be his win, it's on him for the loss as well. Thanks to Joe Mahalik for joining us today on the Bat Buffalo Main Event. Be sure to check out our website once again. It's buffalomainevent.com. It's the best website in the world. And you can win stuff by going there. So definitely check it out. We'll be back with you next week here on the Bat Buffalo Main Event.